Hey everyone and welcome back to our UT Source channel. Today we're gonna learn few things about this small transistor looking device. Actually, it's not a transistor but an LDO. This is the LM2950G, which is a low dropout voltage regulator. This device is an excellent choice for use in a battery powered applications such as cordless telephones, radio control system and portable computers. But wait, where we can buy this from? You can buy this from utsource.net. Link is in video description. So what's an LDO? An LDO or a low dropout regulator is a DC linear voltage regulator that can regulate the output voltage even when the supply voltage is very close to the output voltage. For example, I have a 5 volt power bank circuit but I want to power a microcontroller that operate at 3.3 volts. Now how can I drop this extra 1.7 volt efficiently? Like not wasting any excess power on the heat, which is a common problem when working with the voltage regulators like 7805 or AMS1117. Here's a better alternative. We can use LM2950 LDO in our application to drop 5 volt to 3.3 volt for the microcontroller to work. These are the parameters of this LDO. Input supply voltage of this LDO is 0.3 volt minimum to 30 volt maximum. The output voltage is 3.3 volt and the current is 100 milliampere. Both the output voltage and the current remain stable throughout the operation. It is available in TO92 and SC705L package. There is also exist a 5 volt version of this LDO which can supply 5 volt 100 milliampere stable output for a load. Here's the pinout for this TO92 package LDO that I'm using right now. It has Vout, ground and Vin pin in this arrangement. Also, this is the working schematic that we need to run this LDO. As you can see here, we only required one UF capacitor at Vout, but you can place an extra capacitor at Vin to smooth the voltage. Now, I followed this wiring diagram and set everything on this breadboard. I'm using an ATtiny 13A here, which is preloaded with a classic blink sketch. Also, you can buy this ATtiny 13 from UT Source website as well. After wiring, we just need to supply 5 volt to our setup Vin terminal and everything will work. Now we have to measure the voltage across Vin and ground, which is around 4.5 volt to 4.7 volt. Now we measure voltage across the microcontroller's VCC and ground. As you can see, we are getting 3.3 volt, which is our goal. So this is how you can use an LM2950 LDO with any microcontroller. If this video was helpful, then do not forget to hit the subscribe button. Check out UT Source website for buying discrete electronic component and I'll be back with another video soon. Peace out.